Greetings to all of my friends today from around the world, and all of you that are in the United States, all of you on foreign fields, I thank you for tuning into this broadcast today. It's my privilege to go around the world and preach to you. Many of you have been asking for me to teach you and preach to your congregations, even from this site right here. And so I'm going to share with you today a little bit about my testimony and talk to you about the Lord. Now, this video may be just a little bit longer than usual to accommodate some of the people overseas who are asking for me to send them more information. And so that's what I'm going to do this morning. My experience with the Lord, I was born in Tulsa, Oklahoma. And I thank God for my heritage. Oklahoma is a wonderful state. I was raised by Christian parents who brought me up in the ways of the Lord. My mother took us to church all the time. I really wasn't too interested in church activity at that time until I was about 15 years old. And we moved to a place called Skellytown, Texas. They had a strong group of young people who liked to pray, and many of them were called to preach. And several preachers came out of that location there in Skellytown, Texas, and I'm one of them. And I thank God for the experience I had. They were a praying group, and somehow or another they asked me to bring a message, and I didn't know how to bring a message. I couldn't talk before people. I just was terrified when I'd get before people. But anyway, I put together something. I got up to talk, and I talked about 5 minutes, and I made the biggest mess you ever seen out of trying to make a conversation. I just did the best I could, but it wasn't very good. But anyway, just a few weeks later, a preacher down in Mobile, Texas, asked me to come down and preach for him. And I said, why in the world does a man want me to come and preach for him? I can't really preach. And so I put together the thoughts that I thought might be a 5-minute message. And so it turned out to be a lot different than a little 5-minute message. When I got up behind the pulpit to preach, I began to talk. And all of a sudden, all the fear and the anointing of the Holy Ghost came up on me. And I began to preach like someone has never preached ever before. The strong power of the Holy Ghost come upon me. Folks, I want to tell you, if you're starting out in the ministry today, and if you feel a call to the Lord, one of the most important things that you're empowered by the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is inside of you, and He will give you that anointing and power that you need. I posted just recently on Facebook and other outlets, what we need more than anything else is the power of the Holy Ghost in our life. And friends, that is so true. I preached with all my heart there. And in fact, the pastor that was sitting on the front row, there was only 3 people out there. I preached to a rather large audience, and I preached to all kinds of people. I preached to 3 before. I preached to hundreds before. But I want to tell you what, wherever we preach, God's anointing is going with us. And when I got to preaching, really got into the anointing of the preaching, the pastor of that church got up and shouted. He ran all the way out the back door and all the way around shouting. You could hear him shouting all the time that anointing of God had come up on me. And folks, that night we were staying in a place there provided by Sister Shackelford. She was a wonderful lady who took care of the preachers who come by to preach. And they gave us a little place to spend the night. And I spent the night out there with Brother Jerry Holder. And there with Jerry Holder, we prayed. And we prayed all night long. I tell you what a prayer meeting that night. I have never, ever sensed the presence of God like I did that night. It wasn't that night that I felt the call to preach. I talked in a mighty unknown tongue, the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Some people think if they thought in the book of Acts they were just babbling and they were unlearned men because they spoke in tongues. Folks, I want to tell you the language that we speak in, a heavenly language, is the language of the Holy Ghost. And I tell you, it's ministering unto God. You're talking to God. You're worshiping God. So don't make fun of people that speak in tongues. They're not uneducated. Some of the most educated people in the world have been filled with the mighty baptism of the Holy Ghost. And when the power of God comes up on you, you'll do things. That all-night prayer meeting propelled me into what I was preparing for, a ministry. a ministry. I felt a call of God that night to be active in ministry. I had a lot of zeal. I mean, a lot of enthusiasm. I had fire, didn't have a lot of sense in a lot of cases, but I want to tell you what, I did have the zeal, and I lacked the knowledge of the Word of God, and I needed the Word of God in my life. If you're going to be an effective preacher, you got to understand what the Word is about. You can't just depend upon zeal. You got to depend upon thus saith the Lord, which is found in the Word of God. He'll give you the power, and He'll give you the anointing, and He'll give you everything you need. But study to show yourself approved unto God. That's what Paul said to the young preacher. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. And so you need to do everything you can to apply yourself not only to deep intensity prayer and intercession with God and being filled with the Spirit, but you need to be very active in learning all you can about the Word of God. There's a lot of ways you can do that. In fact, God is using me now to teach some of you that probably don't know too much about what's going on in your life. Be sure that it's a call of God, that God is using you. You can't continue on in life if you don't have the call of God on your life. You're going to end up not being very happy, because it takes the call of God to be sustained. I pastored over the years at several churches. My first church was just a really small church, and we were able to build it up to 25 or 30, and I had to drive everywhere to go pick people up there in Tallulah, Louisiana. That's in Louisiana territory. It was really something that my first church that I ever pastored, and it was there that I went on to Abbeville, Louisiana, where I started applying myself a little bit more and learning the Word of God and really trying to fulfill that part in my life. And that makes a difference when we apply the Word of God to our life. I went on over the years and have been on evangelistic field and preaching meetings. I've had revival meetings where hundreds of people were saved. I've had revival meetings where several were filled with the Holy Ghost. Folks, I want to tell you, I believe in the mighty power of the Holy Ghost. I believe in the power and anointing of God upon us. Jesus was anointed with the Holy Ghost when He went about His active ministry preaching. If Jesus really needed the Holy Spirit and the Holy Ghost in His life, how much more do we need that anointing in our life today? Sometimes I think we're depending a lot on too much advanced analytics and educations nowadays, and sometimes we forget the real source of why we're in the ministry, and that's because we're called to God to win souls and to be an influence on people's life and do what we can. I've made a lot of mistakes in my life as far as they haven't been glamorous mistakes as far as keeping me from being a minister with the Assemblies of God, in which I've been for 50, 60, 61 years exactly. I've had credentials with the Assemblies of God. I feel just as called to preach today as I ever did. I thank God for all the ministry that I've had. I've pastored in Houston, I've pastored in New Mexico, in Lovington First Assembly of God. I've pastored in Cherry Valley, Arkansas. I've pastored in Chautauqua, Kansas. And I've been at Wichita, Kansas, Calvary Assembly of God, there in the big city of Wichita. I've been all over the world preaching the gospel everywhere I can. And I want to tell you what, if you're trying to seek God with your whole heart. Be sure you're called of God. Don't try to do things in yourself, because you can't do it in yourself. Everything that you try to do in yourself will be a failure. And I thank you so much for listening to this broadcast today. If this has been a help to you, please let me know. I'm talking to people in India. I'm talking to people in Pakistan. I'm talking to people in Uganda. I'm talking to people in Kenya. I'm talking to people in Gambia that are saying they want to be taught more of the Word of God. Friends, if you feel called today, answer the call of God. There's a wide open field of people that are hungry for God today. Do your best you can to fulfill what God has for your life. If you will be interested in seeing God move in your life, there's a lot of doors seem to be closed sometimes. Don't worry about the closed door. Just slip into the open doors. Wherever God gives you an opening, do what what you can for the grace of God. If it's teaching in one of the smallest places there is, or if it's going to a rest home, obey God and do what you can, and God will surely bless what you do. I hope this video has been a blessing to you today. Thank you so much for tuning into this broadcast, and I'll talk to you again real soon.